carried on in Whoville liked Christmas a lot, but the Grinch, who lived just north of Whoville, did not.
Grinch hated Christmas the whole Christmas season, but please just don't ask why. No one knows the reason.
Could be perhaps his head wasn't screwed on just right. It could be perhaps his shoes were too tight. But I think the most likely reason of all is that his heart is two sizes too small.
Whatever his heart or his shoes, he's stood there on Christmas Eve hating the Whos.
Staring down from his cave with a sour, grinchy frown at the warm light windows below in their town. Oh, he knew every Who down in Whoville beneath was busy now hanging a mistletoe wreath.
They're hanging their stockings, he sneered with a sneer. Tomorrow is Christmas, it's practically here.
Then he growled with his Grinch fingers nervously drumming, I must find some way to stop Christmas from coming.
For tomorrow, he knew all the Who girls and boys would wake bright and early, they'd rush for their toys.
And then, oh the noise, 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 that's one thing. He hated the noise, noise, noise.
Then Who's young and old would sit down to a feast, and they'd feast, 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 feast.
They would feast on Who pudding and wear Who's beast, so something the Grinch could stand in the least.
Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, would stand close together with Christmas bells ringing. They'd stand hand in hand and the Whos would start singing.
They sing and they sing and they sing, sing, sing.
And the more the Grinch thought of this Who Christmas thing, the more the Grinch thought, I must stop this whole thing.
Why, for 53 years I've put up with it now. I must stop this Christmas from coming, but how?
Then he got an idea, an awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea. I know what just to do. The Grinch laughed in his throat, and he made a quick Santa Claus hat and a coat.
And he chuckled and cuckled. What a grey, grudgy trick.
This coat and this hat, I look just like Saint Nick.
All I need is a reindeer. The Grinch looked around. But since reindeers are scarce, there are none to be found.
Did that stop the old Grinch? No, the Grinch simply said, if I can't find a reindeer, I'll make one instead.
Called his dog Max, then he took some red thread and tied it onto the top of his head.
Then he loaded some bags and some old empty sacks on a ramshack sleigh and he hitched up old Max.
The Grinch said, get up! And the sleigh started down.
Toward the homes where the Whos listen Who's in their town.
All the windows were dark. Quiet snow filled the air.
The Whos were all dreaming sweet dreams without care when he came to the first little house on the square.
This is stop number one. The old Grinch Claus hissed. And he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist.
Then he slipped down the chimney and rarity pinch. But if Santa could do it, so can the Grinch. He got stuck only once for a moment or two. Then he stuck his head out of the fireplace flue.
Where'd the little Who stockings all hung in a row? These stockings, he grinned, are the first things to go. Then he suddenly slunk with a smile most unpleasant around the whole room and he took every present.
Popcorns and bicycles, roller skate drums, checkerboards, tricycles, popcorn and plums.
And he stuffed them in bags. Then the Grinch, very nimbly, stuffed all the bags, one by one, up the chimney.
He slunk to the icebox. He took the Who's feast. He took the Who pudding and he took the roast feast.
He cleaned out the icebox as quick as a flash. Why that Grinch even took their last can of Who hash. He stuffed all the food up the chimney with glee. And now, grinned the Grinch, I will stuff up the tree.
And the Grinch grabbed the tree and he started to shove when he heard a small sound like a coo of a dove. He turned around fast and he saw a small Who. Little silly little Who was not more than two.
The Grinch had been caught by this tiny Who daughter who'd got out of bed for a cup of cold water.
Stared at the Grinch and said, Santa Claus, why? Why are you taking our Christmas tree? Why?
But you know the old Grinch is so smart and so slick. He thought up a lie and he thought it up quick.
Why, my sweet little tot, the fake Santa Claus lied. There's a light on this tree that will not light on this on one side.
So I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there, then I'll bring it back here.
And he fibbed through the child, then he patted her head, and he got her a drink and sent her to bed. And when Cinderella Who went to bed with her cup, he went to the chimney and stuck the tree up.
Then the last thing he took was the log for the fire. Then went up the chimney himself, the old liar. On the walls he left nothing but hooks and some wire.
And the one speck of food I left in the house was a crumb that was even too small for a mouse. Meep, 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 meep.
Then he did the same thing to the other three houses, leaving crumbs much too small for another Who's mouses.
It was quarter past dawn, all Who's still abed, all Who's still snooze when he packed up his sled.
Packed it up with the presents, the ribbons, the wrappings, the tie and the tinsel, the trimming, the trappings.
3,000 feet up the side of Mount Crumpet, he rode with his load to the tip top to dump it.
Pee-pee to the Who's, he was grinchously humming. They're finding out now that no Christmas is coming. They're just waking up. I'll know just what they'll do. Their mouths will hang open in a minute or two. Now the Who's don't know who, they will all cry, boo-hoo!
Grinned the Grinch, that I simply mocked here. So he pulled and put his, and the Grinch put his hand to his ear.
Did hear a sound rising over the snow. It started in low, then it started to grow.
But the sound wasn't sad. Why, the sound's only merry. It couldn't be so, but it was merry, very. He stared down at Whoville. The Grinch popped his eyes. What he saw was a shocking surprise. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presents at all.
He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came, somehow or other. It came just the same.
And the Grinch with his grin tree, as cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so? It came without ribbons, it came without tags, it came without packages, boxes or bags.
And he puzzled 3 hours till his puzzle was sore, and the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before.
Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas perhaps means a little bit more.
And what happened then? Well, in Hoover, they say that the Grinch was small at Christie's sizes that day.
And the minute his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whizzed his load through the bright morning light.
And he brought back the toys and the food for the feast, and he himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast.
Hit it!
Santa Claus coming to town, oh yeah! Santa costume.